गुड मॉर्निंग टू एवरी वन. आई एम गणेश, डीएल इन कॉमर्स एट द TTRSC वुमेन्स उटनूर. इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू अबाउट एक्सप्लेन अबाउट द बिल्स ऑफ एक्सचेंज. बिल्स ऑफ एक्सचेंज मीन्स इट इज ए रिटन डॉक्यूमेंट विच इज ड्रॉन बाय द क्रेडिटर एंड एक्सेप्टेड बाय द ड्राई. जनरली इन बिजनेस वी हैव टू टाइप्स ऑफ ट्रांजेक्शन्स. फर्स्ट वन इज द कैश ट्रांजेक्शन एंड सेकेंड वन इज द credit transactions. When the cash transactions are taken place, we have no problem about the debit nets. But credit transactions are taken place, we have the problem about the debit nets. That's why the creditor has a draw a document on buyer or debtor. So that document will be accepted from debtor. So after taking acceptance from the debtor, the document is treated as a bill. Now we see the definition about the bill of exchange, which is given by the Indian Negotiable Instrument Act of 1881. Means bills are second one is a promissory note and third one is a bill. So now we see about the bill of exchange. So as per section 5 of Indian Negotiable Instrument Act of 1881, a bill of exchange is an instrument in writing containing an unconditional order signed by the maker directing a certain person to pay a certain sum of money only to or to the order of a certain person or to the bearer of the instrument. Means the bill of exchange, it is an instrument or it is a document which is in the form of written, and it is also containing a unconditional order regarding payment of money on the due date of bill. It is also signed by the maker. Means who draws the bill, that person has to be compulsory signed on that document. It is also directing a certain person. Means this bill is directing a creditor debtor to pay the amount on certain sum of money. Means how much of amount to received from creditor, that amount has to be paid on a certain date. Means after the due date. So the amount has to be paid to the person whom the amount has to be received. So the receivable person will be the drawer or the other persons which is given a order to pay the amount, and or the who is having bearer of the instrument, means who is the having of a bill, that person has to be receive the money on the due date. So it is a definition given by the Indian Negotiable Instrument Act of 1881. Now we see the about the features and characteristics of bills of exchange. So as per above definition, we can see the some features or characteristics of bills of exchange. So first it is a written document. It is the first feature or characteristic of bills of exchange. The bill is in the form of written. So it will be used as a legal evidence in future correspondence, and it should be essential include an unconditional order to pay. So in this bill has to give an order to the debtor which is unconditional regarding payment of money. Means at the time of payment there is no conditions regarding payment. And it is an order to pay a certain sum of money at a specified later date. And means this bill is giving an order to pay the certain sum of money, means how much of amount received from the creditor, that amount has to be paid on a specified later date, means after the bill period or after the maturity of the date. The person or the debtor has to be pay the amount. So this order as mentioned in the bill, it is required to be duly signed and stamped by the drawer. So means on this document the drawer or the creditor or the seller has to be compulsory signed on that document. Without signing, the document is not treated as a bill. And also, the drawer has a paste attached the required stamps as per the bill value. Stamps. These two are the must in bill. So without sign or without stamp attaching required stamps, that bill is not treated as a bill. And also it is required to it is accepted by the debtor. Not only signing the maker of bill, maker on the bill, and stamping the attaching stamps on bill, it is also requires the acceptance of the drawee or acceptance of the debtor. Without taking acceptance, the bill is not a valuable. Before the accepting of the bill, that bill is called as a draft bill. After the accepting the drawing, the bill is treated, the draft bill is treated as a bill of exchange, and it is a legal evidence of debt. Means this bill is useful for future. If the debtor has not paid amount on due date, the drawer has used this one as a legal evidence. Means the drawer sue a case on dry. So it will be used as a legal evidence. So these are the some features or characteristics of a bill of exchange. Now we see the specimen of bill of exchange. So it is the specimen of bill of exchange. So we have to write the amount of the bill of the amount, and attach the stamps at the left side corner. Stamps means how much stamps required as per the Indian Negotiable Instrument Act, that valued stamps are attached on the bill. And also we write the address of the maker or address of the drawer in the right side of the corner. So in this we have mentioned this amount is 10,000 in right side, Utnur district, Adilabad. Date means on which date the bill is drawn. That date has to be entered in the bill. Without the date, the bill is not valuable. Means this date is useful to for calculation of maturity date. That's why we have to mention the date in bill, on the bill. And next we have to see the main part of the bill. That is 3 months after date paid to me or to my order, the sum of rupees 10,000 only for value received. So this bill is directing a person regarding payment of money which is a received value, means which is received from creditor. That is 10,000 has received from creditor. That's why the amount has to be paid after the 3 months. After the 3 months means the bill date is 1st May 2021. After the 3 months means we have to add the 3 months to the months. Means May, June, July. August. June, 3 months means we have to add the 3 months means it is the August. 1st August 2021. And add the as per section 22 of Indian Instrument so the due date will be 4th August 2021. It is the main part. And we have to mention the address of the drawing in the left corner below the bill. Here I have written to Mahesh, Adilabad. And right side corner we have to write the name of the drawer and make a signature on that. In between, the drawer has to be write the accepted and make a signature and with date. So this is the specimen of a bill of exchange. So as per this bill, the Suresh is drawing the bill. That's why the Suresh is treated as a drawer or is a creditor. And the bill is drawn on Mahesh. The bill is drawn on Mahesh. That's why. So Mahesh is treated as a debtor or is a drawing. Next, the amount has to be paid by the Mahesh after the 3 months. Means the bill is written on 1st May 2021. Then 3 months means we have to add the 3 months. So 3 months, it is the 5th month. May means it is the 5th month. Add the 3 months. We will get the August 1st, 2021. As per Section 22 Indian Negotiable Instrument Act, we have to add the 3 grace period. So, maturity date will be August 4th, 2021. On that day, the Mahesh has to be paid the 10,000 rupees to the Suresh. So, it is the specimen of bill. Now, we see the various parties involved in the bill of exchange. In the bill of exchange, the 3 parties are involved: drawer, drawee, and payee. Drawer means who makes the bill, means who draws the bill. That person is called as a drawer. Generally, the seller or the creditor draws a bill. That's why he is treated as a drawer. And he sell goods on credit. He sell goods on credit. That person draws a bill. So, it is regarding about the drawer. And now see the drawee. It is the second party of the bill. Drawee means the person upon whom the bill of exchange is drawn. Means on whom the bill is drawn. That person is called as a drawee. So, now we see the specimen of the bill. So, as per specimen of the bill, the Suresh is drawing the bill. That's why the Suresh is called as a drawer. And the bill is drawn on Mahesh. That's why the Mahesh is treated as a drawee. The drawee has to be make a signature on the bill by writing accepted and make a signature with date. So it is the responsibility of the drawee. Now we see the third party, that is payee. Payee means the person who receives the money on the maturity of the bill, means on the due date. Means as per the above example, on 4th August 2021, who receives the person, that person is treated as a maturity of the bill. That time the drawer or the creditor or the seller has treated as a payee. Means he retaining the bill till the maturity of the bill, and on the due date he give a bill to the drawee and receive the money from that person. So that situation, the drawer is treated as a payee. If the drawer discount the bill with his bank, that time the payee will be bank. Means the drawer make a discount bill in the bank. Means the bill is given to the bank and the amount received from the bank. Then the relationship in between the bank and drawer. So on the due date, the bank give the bill to the drawer. The drawer pay the amount to the bank. That's why the payee will be bank at the time of discounting bill in the bank or with the bank. If the drawee endorses the bill to his creditor, that time the payee will be the endorsee. For example, Suresh have to pay the amount to Naresh. So he have no money to pay the amount. That's why Suresh is giving this bill to Naresh. On the 4th August 2021, the Mahesh will be paid the amount on this bill. That's why you take this one. And on 4th August 2021, you give this bill to the Mahesh and receive the amount from him. So the ender in this situation, the NRC will be the paying. If the drawer sent bill to the bank for collection, that time the bank will be treated as a paying. Means how the bill is used by the drawer, the payee will be changes. Means if the bill is retained by with him till the maturity, that time the drawer is treated as a payee. If the person or if the drawer discount the bill in the bank, that time the payee will be bank. If the drawer endorse the bill, that time the NRC will be treated as a paying. If the drawer sent to the bill for collection to the bank, that time also the bank will be treated as a paying. Means how the bill is used by the drawer, the payee will be changes. So these are the parties involved in bills of exchange. So there are three parties: drawer, drawee, and payee. Drawer means who draws the bill. Generally, seller or creditor draws the bill. That's why he is treated as a drawer. And on whom the bill is drawn, that person is treated as a drawee. That person is treated as a payee. So these are the parties involved in bills of exchange. Now we see about the classification of bills of exchange. So as per the bill of nature of the bill of exchange, the bills are classified in various types. Now we see the first type, that is trade and accommodation bills. Means trade bills and accommodation bill. As per their nature, it is classified as a trade bill or and accommodation bill. These are the two separate types. Now we see the trade bill. When a bill of exchange is drawn and accepted for genuine trade transaction, it is called as a trade bill. Means if any person sell a goods on credit and after selling the goods, the seller has to be draw a document or draw a bill on buyer. So that bill is treated as a trade bill. Means if any trade transactions taken place, that is credit transactions, that time the bill is drawn, that bill is treated as a trade bill. When a bill is drawn for the mutual help of the parties concerned, that is to provide the funds needed, it is called as a accommodation bill. If any one or two persons need a amount for short period, then the two persons make a agreement between them and draws a bill on one person to the second person. After the accepting that bill, that bill has to be discounted with the bank. Means this bill is giving to the bank and receive amount from that bank. After the maturity of the bill, the drawee has to be paid the amount to the bank. So this is the accommodation bill. Whichever amount is received from the bank, that amount has to be distributed among the persons. Among the persons means the drawer and drawee as per their agreement. If you the amount is needed for two persons, that amount has to be distributed within the two persons. If the amount is needed for only one person, the person has the amount has to be taken by that person only. So this is the accommodation bill. In this type of bill, there is no transactions taken place, credit transactions taken place. It is only for mutual help purpose for short period, and it is useful to the business persons. Now we'll see the second type of bill of exchange, that is time and demand bill. So when a bill is payable after a certain period of time, it is called as a time bill. Means the period will be mentioned in the document or in the bill. That bill is called as a time bill. As per this bill, we know on which date the amount has to be received from the debtor, or on which date the amount has to be paid to the creditor. So clearly the time is mentioned in this bill. That's why it is treated as a, or it is called as a we give a 3 days of grace period. Means after the due date or after the bill period, we have to add the additional 3 days as a grace period. So it is a time bill. Means the time is mentioned in the bill. But whereas the bill is made payable on demand, it is called as a demand bill. In this type of bill, there is no time mentioned or on which date the amount has to be paid or on which date amount has to be received from the debtor. That period or that time is not mentioned in this bill. Means on which date the creditor asks the amount, that day amount has to be paid by the debtor. So there is no clarity about the payment of the time. So it is called as a demand bill. For this bill, the Negotiable Instrument Act is not allowed a 3 days of grace period. So it is regarding time and demand bill. Time bill means the time will be mentioned in the bill, that is treated as, or that is called as a time bill. The time is not mentioned in the bill, that bill is called as a demand bill. Now we see the third type, inland and foreign bill. Inland and foreign bill. The bill is drawn and payable within the boundaries of one country is called as a inland bill. Means the bill is drawn and payable, whichever any one is taken within the country, the drawer and drawee both are the residents of a Indian. The drawing of the bill and payment of the bill as made within the country or within the boundaries of India, so that bill is treated as a inland bill. If the bill is drawn or payable outside of the country, is called foreign bill. Means if any bill is drawn or amount is payable outside of the India or outside of the country, that bill is treated as a foreign bill. Means any one event is taken place outside of the country, so that bill is called as, or that bill is treated as a foreign bill. So these are the classification of bills of exchange. In classification of bills of exchange, we discuss about the trade and accommodation bill, time and demand bill, inland and foreign bill. Now we see the advantages of bills of exchange. So as per the definition of the bill, we can see some of our advantages of bill of exchange. First one is the bill serves as a written evidence of indebtedness of the drawee. Means this bill is useful as a legal evidence at the time of at the time of drawee not paid the amount on the maturity. This bill in the court and collecting amount from the drawee by the court. Okay, it is the first advantage. Now see the bill serves as a source of finance for drawer. Means it is useful as a source of finance. One type of source of finance. It is for short period. How the it is used as a source of finance? These are the two ways. First one is the discounting the bill in the bank. And second one is the accommodation bill. In these two ways, the drawer uses this bill as a source of finance. Means, if the bill accepted by the drawee as amount as paid the amount after the maturity of the period or maturity of the bill. But before the maturity of the bill, the drawer need the amount. That's why he give a bill to the bank, means he is discounting bill to the in the bank bill and receive the amount from bank. By this way he using amount from receiving amount from bank. Now already we discussed about the accommodation bill. It is financial planning can be alone by all the persons. All the persons, parties concerned with more accuracy when the due dates for payment of bills are known. So, as per this bill of exchange, we can know on which date the amount we have received from the drawee. And on which date the amount has to be paid by the drawee to the drawer. We know about these days. That's why we can plan about the amount. The drawer on that date, on that date, I am receiving amount from that person or drawee. So that amount has to be used for this purpose. So like he is planning about the finance. And the drawee has to know the date, on which date he has to be pay the amount. That's why he make a arrangement to payment the amount on this bill. So these are the some example advantages of bill of exchange. Now we'll see the recording of bills of exchange. There are two methods used by the business concerns recording the bill of exchange. If the number of bills are large number, the business concern has to be used the subsidiary books for entering transactions regarding bills of exchange, that is bills receivable book and bills payable book. If the number of transactions related to bills of exchange is very few, that time the business concern has to be used general or enter the general entries in the book or passing the general entries in the general. So these are the two methods used by the business concerns maintain the bills receivable book and bills payable book. In bills receivable book, they have to use to write enter the transactions regarding acceptance, drawing and acceptance of the bill and receiving of the bill. In bills payable book, the drawee has to be used to enter the transactions, acceptance of the bill and payment of the bill. In general entries, on in general, when the transactions are very few number of bills of exchange, the business concern are used to enter the transactions in journal and enter the general entries are made in the journal and posted to the ledger accounts. In this situation, the business concern had to enter the general entries or passing the general entries in the general. After the passing general entries in the general, the business concerns or accountant has to be post this entries into the ledger. In this situation, they have to enter the transactions in the ledger book, bills receivable account. For drawer ledger, bills payable account for drawee accounts and personal accounts. In drawer books, the drawee account will be make or drawn. In the drawee books, the drawer account. So these are the methods used for the entering the transactions in bill of exchange. Now we see the accounting treatment of bill of exchange. There are some of the events, means how the problem is asked. There are 6 types of problems asked in the examinations. They are the first, if the bill is retained by the drawer till the due date, and drawer discounting the bill in with his bank, or the drawer endorsed the bill to the his creditor, or the drawer send the bill to the bank for collection. So these are the main four types, including renewal of bill and retirement of bill. Okay, these 6 types of problems asked from this unit. In this video, I am going to discuss about only first 4 types. That is retention of bill till due date, discounting of bills in bank or with the bank, endorsement of bill, and bill sent to the bank for collection. So in these 4 situations, we have the 2 methods, that is honoring of bill and dishonoring of bill. 2 types of problems. Each situation, the problem may be asked in 2 types. If the bill is honored or if the bill is dishonored. Okay, so these are the accounting, it is the accounting treatment of bills of exchange. Now we see the model general entries, how the entries are passed or passing in the general. In second method, we are discussing about the second method, not using bills receivable book and bills payable book. We are entering the transactions in general. How general entries in the books of drawer, means in the books of creditor, in the books of seller, how the general entries are passed. So in the books of drawer, the general entries will be, first general entry for selling of goods on credit, and second one is the acceptance received from the drawee. Third one will be the how the bill is used by the drawer. The drawer has to be used the bill in 4 methods. First one, retention of the bill, discounting the bill, endorsing the bill, and bill sent to the bank for collection. So in 4 situations, how the bill is used by the drawer, so that entry will be recorded or passing in the general. In 4 situations, whether the bill is honored or dishonored. Honored bits, on the due date or on the maturity of the date, the drawee's amount is paid or not. We see the on the maturity date, the drawee is paid the amount or not. If the drawee pays the amount on the date of maturity, that is treated as a honoring of bill. if the drawee has not paid the amount on the maturity of the date or maturity of the bill, that is not treated as a dishonor of bill. So third entry will be recorded how the bill is used and whether the bill is honored or not. So these entries will be entered in the books of drawer. Now we see the entries. For goods sold on credit. For goods sold on credit. In this transaction, the drawer has to be debit the drawee's account or who buying the goods. That person's account is debiting and crediting the sales account. Okay? He has to write the entry like drawee account data to sales account. And second entry, acceptance or drawing the bill and acceptance received from the drawee. So the entry will be bills receivable account data to drawee account. Means he is debiting the bills receivable account and crediting the drawee account. The bill will be treated as a bills receivable, and for drawee it is treated as a bills payable. Okay. After the entering these transactions, now we see how the bill is used. Already we discussed about how the drawer used by bills. He used bill in four situations. One is the retention of the bill, second one is the discounting the bill in the bank with the bank, and third one is the endorsing the bill, and fourth one is the bill sent to the bank for collection. Okay. After we observing how the bill is used, then we can see whether the bill is honored or dishonored. After observing the two informations, then we write the third entry. Now we see the entries. In this situation, we can see whether the bill is honored or dishonored. I have mentioned it in two entries. In two entries, we have to enter only one, any one. If the bill is honored, first entry we have to be entered. If the bill is dishonored, you have to enter the second entry. Now we see the entries. For first situation, which is retained by the drawer, bill is retained by the drawer till the due date. If the bill is honored, means on the due date or on the maturity of the bill, the drawer pays the amount to the drawee. Pays the amount to the drawer. The entry will be cash or bank account data to bills receivable account. It is the entry for bill is honored on the due date. If the bill is dishonored, the entry will be drawee account data to bills receivable account. Means on the due date or on the maturity of the bill, the drawee has not paid amount to the drawer. The entry will be we are debiting the drawee account and creating the bills receivable account. So it is the entries for first situation. Now we see the entries for second situation. That is, if a bill is discounted with the bank by drawer. So in this situation, we have to enter the one or two entries on the situation, on the basis of problem. If the problem is related to honoring of the bill, we have to enter only one entry. That is, the bill is discounted with a bank. If the problem is related to dishonor of bill, we have to enter the two entries. First one for discounting the bill in with the bank, and second one is the dishonoring of the bill. Okay, in this situation or second situation, we have to enter the transactions. If the problem is related to honoring of the bill, we have to enter the only one entry, that is discounting the bank bill with the bank. If the problem is related to dishonor of bill, we have to enter the second one. Okay, now see the general entries. At the time of discounting bill with the bank by the drawer, we have to enter the general entry like bank account debtor, discount account debtor to receivable account, bills receivable account. So it is the entry for discounting bill with the bank. So in this entry, we are debiting bank account and the discount account. Amount, how much amount is giving bank to the drawer, that amount has to be record entered in the bank account. And how much amount in the column of debit column of discount account. Okay, next we have to credit the bills receivable account. So it is the entry for bill discounted with a bank. If the problem is related to honoring of the bill, there is no entry in the drawer book. But whereas the bill is dishonored, the entry will be dry account debtor to bank account. So this entry for dishonoring of bill which is discounted with the bank. Okay, the entry dry account debtor to bank account. So it is the second situation. Now we see the third situation. If the bill is endorsed by the drawer to his creditor. So in this situation, we have to see whether the bill is honored or dishonored. If the bill is honored, we have to write only one entry, that is endorsing the bill. If the bill is dishonored, we have to write the two entries. First one, endorsing of the bill, and second one is the dishonoring of bill. Okay, now we see the entries for this situation. So in this situation, we have to this type of problems, we have to enter the transactions in three parties. First one, general entries in the books of drawer, general entries in the books of dry, general entries in the books of NRC. NRC means the bill is endorsed to whom, that person is called as a NRC. Okay, the whom, the person who endorsing receives the bill. Okay, now we see the general entries in the books of drawer only. When the bill is endorsed, the entry will be endorsee account debtor to bills receivable account. Endorsee means to whom the bill is endorsing, endorsed. Okay, for example, as per our specimen of bills of exchange, the Suresh is endorsing bill to Naresh. So Naresh is treated as a endorsee. So we have to write the entry like Naresh account debtor to bills receivable account. Okay, after entering this entry, now we see whether the bill is honored or dishonored. If the bill is honored, there is no entry in the books of drawer. This entry will be in the books of endorsee. Honored. If the bill is honored, the honored entry will be in the books of endorsee. but there is no entry in the books of draw. If the bill is dishonored, the entry will be, or we have to debit the drawee's account and credit the endorsee account. The entry drawee account debtor to endorsee account. Okay, it is the third situation. Whether the bill is honored or dishonored. In two situations. Second situation means if the bill is discounted with the bank or if the bill is endorsed. If the bill is honored, we have to write only one entry. If the bill is discounted with the bank, we have to enter the discounting of the bill entry. In the books, if the bill is endorsed, we have to write the endorsement of bill entry. If the bill is dishonored, we have to write the two entries. In the second situation, for first one, discounting of the bill, and second one is the dishonor of the bill. In third situation, it is the endorsement of bill. We have to write the endorsing of the bill, and second one is the dishonoring of the bill. Now we see the fourth type of fourth situation. Means number of bills or more in the hands of drawer, the drawer has to be make a request to the bank. Means these bills are, all the bills are sent to the bank and make a request to the bank, please collect the amount on the maturity of the date bill and credit the amount in my account. So in this way, it is called as a bill is sent to bank for collection. In this situation, we have to write two entries. Whether the bill is honored or bill is dishonored, there is no difference. We have to write the entries two. First one, sending bill to the bank. And second one, if the whether the bill is honored or bill is dishonored. If the bill is honored, we have to write the honored entry. If the bill is dishonored, we have to write the dishonored entry. Now we see the entries. When bill is sent to the bank for collection, the entry will be bill sent to the bank for collection account data to bills receivable account. For in this situation, we have to open a new account. That is bill sent to bank for collection account. Okay, all the entries are which are sent to the bank for collection, that bills are entered in this account. Okay, the entry will be bills sent to the bank for collection account data to bills receivable account. After the entering this transaction, we have to see whether the bill is honored or dishonored. If the bill is honored, on the maturity of the bill, we have to write the entry like bank account debtor to bill sent to the bank collection, bank for collection account. Means we are debiting the bank account and crediting the bill sent to the bank for collection account. If the bill is dishonored, the entry will be dry account debtor to bill sent to the bank for collection account. If the bill is dishonored, we are debiting the dry account and crediting the bill sent to the bank for collection account. So these are specimen entries entered in or enter the general entries in the books of drawer. Now we see the general entries in the books of drawee. In the books of drawee, we have to enter only three entries only. That is, first one, goods purchased on credit. And second one, acceptance given on the bill. Third one, whether the bill is honored or dishonored. If the bill is honored, we have to write the honoring bill, honored entry. If the bill is dishonored, we have to write the dishonored bill entry. Okay, now we see the entries. When the goods purchased on credit, the DRI has to be pass the general entry like purchases account debtor to drawer account. Means we are debiting the purchases account and creating the DRI account. After the purchasing of the bill, the drawer draws a bill on DRI. The bill is sent to the DRI. After the receiving the bill by DRI, the DRI has to be accept, give a accept on that bill. When we give a acceptance on that bill, the entry will be drawer account debtor to bills payable account. Means we are debiting the drawer account and creating the bills payable account. Why we are writing in the books of bills payable account? By this bill, the DRI has to be pay the amount to the some other persons. That is why it is called as a bills payable. Okay, so we are writing in the books of bills payable. Same bill, the bill is treated for drawer, that is bills receivable for DRI, it is treated as a bills payable. Okay, after the entering this transaction, now we see whether the bill is honored or dishonored. Okay, if the bill is honored, we have to write the entry, or we are debiting the bills payable account and crediting the cash and bank account. Means the bills payable account debtor to cash or bank account. It is the entry for honoring of bill. Means the DRI pays the amount to the drawer on the maturity of the bill. Okay? If the bill is dishonored, in this situation we can see, we have to see whether the noting charges are paid by the drawer or not. If the noting charges are not given in the problem, only dishonoring of the bill, we have to write the entries like bills payable account debtor to drawer account. At the time of dishonoring of in the problem, the entry will be bills payable account debtor, noting charges account debtor to drawer account. So these are the entries entered in the books of DRI. Now we see the some of the examples problems or illustration problems regarding bills of exchange. So first situation, see the problem. On 1st January 2014, A sold goods to B of the value of 1500 and drew upon the latter on 3 months for the amount. B accepted the bill and returned it to A. On the due date, the bill was duly met. Pass entries in the books of A and B. It is the problem. In this problem, on 1st January 2014, A is selling goods to B worth rupees 1500 on credit base. On the same day, A is drawing a bill on B for 3 months. After the drawing of bill, the bill is accepted by the B and it is returned to A. On the date, due date, the bill was duly met. Duly met means the bill is honored. Means on the due date, the B has paid amount to the A. In this problem, they are asking the past general entries in the books of A and B. Okay, it is the problem. Now we see. First of all, before entering the passing the general entries, we have to decide who is the drawer and who is the drawee. Already we discussed before. Drawer means who draws the bill. That person is treated as a drawer. As per this problem, A is drawing the bill. That's why A is treated as a drawer. Drawee. The bill is drawn on B. A is drawing bill on B. That's why B is treated as a drawee. Okay. After the deciding the parties, who is the drawer and who is the drawee. Next, we have to calculate the date of maturity. How the date of maturity will be calculated? First, take the date of the bill. And we have to add the bill period. Means, how many months after the amount has to be paid by the drawee. That period has to be added to the bill date. After adding the bill period, we have to add the grace period, that is 3 days, to this date. After adding the grace days, which date is came? That is, it is called as a maturity of date, bill, date of maturity. Okay? The bill period 3 months. So we have to add the 3 months to 1st January. So after adding 3 months, the date will be 1st April 2014. Then we have to add the 3 grace days, grace period, 3 days. So 1st April 2014 plus 3 days means 4th April 2014 will be the maturity date or due date. On 4th April 2014, B has to be paid the amount to A. After making this working note, then we pass the entries in the books of drawer and in the books of drawee. So already we decided, we observed A is the drawer and B is the drawee. So make an heading, that is general entries in the books of A, in bracket we have to write the drawer. Okay, already in early we discussed how the entries are entered in the drawer book. So in the drawer's book we have to write the entries, first one for credit selling of goods, and second one acceptance received from the drawee, and third one honoring or dishonoring of the bill. Okay, now we see the entries. On 1st January we are writing the entry for selling of goods. So A is selling goods to B, that's why we are debiting the B account and creating the sales account. So the entry will be B account debtor to sales account. In debit column, you have to write the amount 1500 rupees. In credit column also 1500 rupees. After entering this entry, you have to write the second entry. Same date. A drew a bill on B and B is accepted on bill. Both the events are done in the same day. So that's why same date, that is January 1st, 2014. in date column. The entry will be, what is the entry? B is giving acceptance, or A is receiving acceptance on bill from B. The entry will be bills receivable account data to B account. The amount in debit column 1500 rupees, in credit column also 1500 rupees. Narration, being acceptance received for 3 months from B. Okay. Next, third one, before writing the third entry, we can see how the bill is used by the drawer. The bill is retained by him till the due date, or whether the bill is discounted in the bank, or whether the bill is endorsed, or whether the bill is sent to the bank for collection. So, in this problem, they have not mentioned how the bill is used by the drawer. If the situation is not mentioned in the problem, we can treat it as a bill is retained by the drawer till the due date. Next. So already they mentioned the bill was duly met. Duly met means on the due date the B has paid amount to the A. Means it is honored. So on 4th April 2014, the entry will be cash account data to bills receivable account for receiving payment on bill. So these are entries in the books of drawer. Okay. Now see the entries in the books of drawee. Means in this problem the entry will be B is the drawee. So we see in the books of drawing, we have to write the general entries for first one, goods purchased on credit, and second one, acceptance given on the bill, and third one is the honoring of bill. So as per this problem, okay, first entry for goods purchased on credit, the entry will be purchases account data to A account. Means we are debiting the purchase account and creating the A account. Narration, being the goods purchased on credit from A. So it is the first entry. And second entry for acceptance given on the bill. The entry will be A account data to bills payable account. Means we are debiting the drawer account and creating the bills payable account. So in this problem, A is the drawer. That's why we are debiting the A account and creating the bills payable account. The entry will be being acceptance given on bill for 3 months. After the 3 months, on 4th April 2014, the B is paying the amount to the A. That's why we have to write the entry like bills payable account data to cash account. Narration, being the amount paid on bill. Okay. So these are the entries in the books of drawee. It is the illustration problem for first situation. Means the bill is retained by the drawer till the due date. Now we see the second situation. That is discounting of a bill. See the problem. Jimmy sold goods to Johnny for rupees 2000 on credit on 18th July 2015 and received from him a bill of 3 months for 2100, which includes 100 for interest for credit period of sale. Give general entries in the books of both parties when bill is discounted immediately at 6% per annum. When the bill is discounted immediately at 9% per annum, the bill is met on due date. So it is a problem. Now we see the problem once again. Jimmy is selling goods to Johnny worth rupees 2000 on 18th July 2015. And he received a bill from, means he received acceptance from but acceptance received for 2100. The difference 100 rupees is treated as a interest for this credit period, and also bill period is 3 months. They are asking, give the journal entries in the books of both the parties, means in the books of Jimmy and in the books of Johnny. They have given two situations. When the bill is discounted immediately, means on the acceptance received on the same day, the drawer has discounted bill in the bank. If the bill is discounted in the bank at the rate of 6% per annum, it is the first situation. And second situation, when the bill is discounted immediately at 9% per annum, means we have to enter the transactions. If the bill is discounted at the 6% per annum, and second one is the, if the bill is discounted in the bank 9% per annum. On the due date, bill is met. Met means the bill is honored. Means the drawee pay the amount to drawer. Now we see the general entries. Before writing general entries, already we discussed, we have to find out who is the drawer and who is the drawing. So in this problem, Jimmy is selling goods. That's why Jimmy is a drawer. And John is buying goods or purchasing goods from Jimmy. That's why John is treated as a drawee. The maturity date. The selling date, 18th July 2015. We have to add the 3 months. Bill period, 3 months. So July, 3 months means it is the 7th month. To add this 3 months means it is 10. So 18th October 2015. Then we have to add the 3 grace days, grace period, 3 days. So date will be 21st October 2015. Okay, already we find that who is the drawer and who is the drawee, and we have also calculated the date of maturity. After making this working note, we have to enter the transactions in the books of drawer. So first entry for selling goods on credit, that is Johnny account data to sales account to interest account. So 100 is giving interest on for a credit period. That's why we have to credit the interest account. So for this one, for selling of goods, and we are receivable interest from credit period. The entry, Johnny account data to sales account to interest account. Okay, after entering this transaction, we have to enter the second entry. Which entry? Acceptance received by Jimmy or received from Jimmy. Okay, the entry will be bills receivable account data to Johnny account. We are receiving acceptance from Johnny. That's why we have to write the entry, bills receivable account data to Johnny account. Okay, next second, third one for before writing third entry, we have to see how the bill is used. Two interest rates are given, 6% per annum and 9% annum. If the bill is discounted 6% per annum, what is the entry? You have to write. If the bill is discounted at the bank with 9%, what is the entry? You have to write. Okay? First of all, we see the discounted bill with the bank at the rate of 6% per annum. The discount will be calculated by using this formula: bill amount into rate of interest divided by 100 into bill period. Bill period means from the date of discounting to the date of maturity. We have to calculate the period from on which day we have to discounting the bill to maturity date. How many days we have that days has to be mentioned, and divided by 12. Okay, by using this formula we have to calculate the discount. Once again I am explaining the discount formula: bill amount into discount rate divided by 100 into period. Period means from the date of discounting to due date divided by 12. If the days are given, then you have to write the in the place of 12 we have to write the 365 or 360 days. If the months are given, then you have to write only 12. Okay, by using this formula we have to calculate the discount. After calculating discount, we have to enter the transaction. What is the transaction for discounting? Bank account debtor, discount account debtor to bills receivable account. Okay, it is the third entry. For if the bill is discounted at the 6% per annum, by using that formula, the discount is 31.50 rupees. Means the bank is reducing 31.50 rupees remaining amount. In 2100, they are reducing 31.50 rupees. Remaining amount means 2068.50 rupees has to be paid to the drawer by the bank. So that's why we are debiting the bank account with ₹2068.50 and also debiting the discount account with the rupees of 31.50 rupees and creating the bills receivable account 2100. Okay, it is the entry for bills discounted with bank. After entering this transaction, we have to see whether the bill is honored or dishonored. If the bill is honored, there is no entry in the books of drawer. If the bill is dishonored, we have to write, already we discussed, what is the entry? Drawee account data to bank account. So it is not related to this problem. So it is the third entry. Fourth entry for what? If the bill is discounted with the bank by 9% per annum, by using discounting formula, calculate the discount amount. ₹25 reduced by the bank, remaining amount has to be paid to the drawer. How much amount paid by the bank? That is ₹2052.75. The entry. Bank account debtor means we are debiting the bank account with ₹52.75. And we are also debiting the discount account with the ₹47.25. And creating the bills receivable account with ₹2100. Okay, the entry: bank account debtor, discount account debtor to bills receivable account. So these are the entries in the books of drawer. Now we see the entries in the books of drawee. Who is the drawee? Johnny. Okay, Johnny is purchasing goods on credit. So first entry will be goods purchased on credit, and second one is for acceptance given on bill, third one for payment of bill. Okay, first we have to write the entry for goods purchased on credit. The entry will be purchases account debtor, interest account debtor to Jimmy account. Why are you adding interest account? He is giving 100 rupees as the interest for credit period. That's why we are mentioning or we are debiting the interest account. Okay? So, entry, purchases account data, it is debited with 2000 rupees and interest account is debited with 100 rupees. So, Jimmy account. After entering this transaction, we have to write the transactions regarding acceptance given on bill. That is Jimmy account data to bills payable account. The entry will be Jimmy account data to bills payable account. Amount same 2100. Next, second. After writing these two entries, we have to see whether the bill is honored or dishonored. Already in this problem, they are mentioned what the bill is met on due date, means it is honored. So you have to write the entry for honoring of bill. Means Johnny has paying amount to Jimmy. How much amount is paying? He is paying 2100, but he received bank from various different amount. If the discount is received 2068 rupees at 6%, at 9% he received 2052 rupees, so something. Okay, but the drawer has to pay all amounts without reducing discount. Okay, the drawer has to pay the 2100 amount to bank. That's why we have to write the bills payable account data to cash account. Amount is 2100. There is no entry for discounting of bill in the books of drawee. Okay. Now we see the third situation. Endorsement of bill. Sudarshan sold goods to Rajan for 2000 on 1st April 2015. Rajan accepts two bills. Rupees 1000 each for 3 months. The books of Sudarshan and Rajan. So it is a problem for situation 3, means the drawer endorsing bills to his creditor. So now we see the problem. What is the problem? Sudarshan is selling goods to Rajan worth rupees 2000 on 1st April 2015. On the same day, Rajan gives acceptance for two bills worth rupees each 1000 rupees. He purchased 2000, but he is accepting two bills. Each bill amount is 1000 rupees. Okay? Say bill period is 3 months. Bill period is 3 months. In these two bills, the Sudarshan endorses one bill to Rakesh. One bill information is given and another one bill is information is not given. Means that is treated as the bill is retained by him. Means retained by the Sudarshan till the due date. Means it is problem related to two situations. First is the bill is endorsed and second one is the bill is retained by the drawer. Pass the general entries in the books of Sudarshan and Rajan. They are asking entries. Enter the general entries in the both parties. In the books of drawer and in the books of drawee. They are not asking in the books of endorsee. In some problems, they are asked pass the general entries in the books of endorsee. Okay? Now we discuss about the problem. Before entering the transactions or before entering the general entries, we have to make some working notes. Find out who is the drawer and who is the drawee and who is the endorsee. So in this problem, there are three parties involved. Who are they? Sudarshan, Rajan and Rakesh. So Sudarshan is selling goods. That's why Sudarshan is treated as a drawer. And Rajan by purchasing goods, or Rajan is accepting the bill. That's why Rajan is treated as a drawer. The Sudarshan endorses the bill to Rakesh. That's why the Rakesh is treated as a endorsing. We decided. We find out who is the drawer, who is the drawee, and who is the endorsee. Then we have to calculate the due date or date of maturity. For this, we have to take the first bill date. Then we have to add the bill period. After adding bill period, we have to add additional 3 days as a grace period. Okay, then we will get the due date or date of maturity. Okay, what is the bill date? April 1st, 2015. He is accepting 2 bills for same period. What is the period? 3 months. So, for these 2 bills, the due date will be same. So, what is the due date? 1st April 2015, you have to add the 3 months bill period. Means July 1st, 2015. Then after adding 3 grace periods, grace days, the maturity date will be, the due date will be 4th April 2015. Now we see the goods sold on credit, and second one acceptance received on bill, and third one is the this problem is two situations. First one endorsing the bill, and second one is the bill is retained by the drawer till the due date, and also bill is met, means it is honored. Now we see the entries. First one, what is the first one? Selling goods on credit. So when we sold goods to some other person, we have to debit the purchaser's account. We are selling goods to Rajan. That's why we are debiting the Rajan account to sales account. Okay? Entry, Rajan account debtor to sales account. Amount rupees 2000. Next, second one. What is the second one? Acceptance received on bill. So, here the Rajan is accepting 2 bills. Each bill value is 1000 rupees. We can write 2 separate entries or any one. Same entry for 2 bills. So, that's why I am only mentioned only 1 account entry. Bills receivable account data to Rajan account. If you want to write the separate entries, amount is 1000, 1000. First one, for second, first bill. And for second bill, same. Bills receivable account data to Rajan account. 1000 rupees, 1000 rupees. Okay? After entering this transaction, the Sudarshan endorses this bill to Rakesh. That's why we have to write the entry for endorsement of bill. What is the endorsement of bill? Entry for endorsement of bill? We have to debit the endorsee account and credit the bills receivable account. So, we are endorsing bills to Rakesh. That's why we are in this problem, the endorsee will be Rakesh. So, we are debiting the Rakesh account and creating the bills receivable account. The entry will be Rakesh account debtor to bills receivable account. Amount is 1000 rupees, 1000 rupees. It is the first bill. For this bill, the bill is honored. So, if the bill is endorsed and it is honored, there is no entry on the due date. Means, bill is closed. The relationship between the Sudarshan and Rajan is closed. Okay? It is the first bill. And second bill. Second bill is retaining by the Sudarshan till the due date. So, we have to write the entry. Cash account data to bills receivable account. Amount 1000 rupees, 1000 rupees. So, these are the 4 entries in the books of Sudarshan, who is the drawer. Next, we see the in the books of Rajan. Means, drawing in the books of, general entries in the books of Drahi. You have to write only 3 or 5. Why I am saying 5? We have to write the entries. If we want to write the entries separate for 2 bills, then you have to write the 5 entries. If you want to write the entry for 2 bills, only 1. So first one for goods purchased on credit, second one accept is giving on bill, third one is the honoring of the bill. So for purchase of goods, you have to debit the purchases account and credit the seller account. Who is the seller? Sudarshan. That's why we are creating the Sudarshan account. So the entry will be purchases account debtor to Sudarshan account. Amount is 2000 rupees. Next, second one. The Rajan is accepting 2 bills worth rupees 1000 each. Okay? If we want to write the entry for 2 bills within one entry, you have to write like this. That is Sudarshan account data drawer to bills payable account. Amount is 2000. Same. Why I am writing this one? Means the bill period is same, acceptance period is same, amount is same. That's why I am written only 1 account. If you want to write the separate entries for a separate bill, then you have to write the same entry for both the bills. What is the entry? Sudarshan account data to bills payable account. The amount will be changed. 1000 rupees, 1000 rupees. We have to write 2 entries. Sudarshan account data to bills payable account, debit 1000 rupees, credit 1000 rupees. First, next, same entry again. Sudarshan account data to bills payable account, 1000 rupees, 1000 rupees. Okay, after writing this entry, we have to see the bill is honored or not dishonored. Already they mentioned the bill is met on due date, means it is the honored. We have to write the same. If you want to write the separate entry for separate bills or command. For command, the entry will be on July 4th, 2015. The entry will be bills payable account data to cash account. Amount is 2000. It is a command entry. If you want to write the separate entries, then you have to write the separate entry same, but amount is different. What is the amount? 1000 rupees. So amount will entry will be bills payable account data to cash account in debit column 1000 rupees, credit column 1000 rupees. Again you have to write same entry, bills payable account data to cash account, amount 1000 rupees, 1000 rupees. Okay, these are the some illustrations problems. 3 methods. First, the bill is retained by the drawee and bill is discounted by the drawer, and bill is endorsed to the creditor. Remaining methods we have to discuss in another video. Okay, thank you.